to that fermentation in the small intestine, there is a formation of some toxic material which get absorbed through your small intestine, your villi, which comes in the blood, and they produces various diseases, then allergic disorder in the skin, that is allergic rashes. Some allergic disorder in various systems, then allergic bronchial asthma. Also, it produces the diseases like rheumatoid arthritis. Also, it produces the diseases like eczema, psoriasis. So, that toxic material in the intestine, which is the part of indigestion, makes the overall problem in the system. And through the regular vamanavriti, we can avoid such vicious circle. We can avoid such long-term diseases. So, it becomes the remedy in long-term diseases. Because in long-term diseases, what happens? Why the patients of psoriasis, why the patients of eczema cannot be cured within some 2 months or 3 months? You see the patients of eczema and psoriasis and allergic skin disorders, they get suffered from that diseases for 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, and the complications slowly increases. Why? Because there is a vicious circle. Due to indigestion, there is a formation of disease, exaggeration of disease, symptoms of disease, and due to exaggeration, there is a disturbed metabolism, again there is a indigestion. So that makes the vicious circle. So that our process of dhauti, we can apply the habit of dhauti, regular practice of dhauti, as a therapeutic procedure in such chronic diseases like bronchial asthma, like psoriasis, like eczema, or like rheumatoid arthritis, or some other systemic disorders.
So this common dhauti, they are good for people who are diabetic?
Yes, good. So habit of that vaman dhauti, not for only one time, habit of vaman dhauti, it is a good remedy for diabetes versus.
Is there any research on the effects of vaman dhauti on diabetics? Does it control, does it cure for diabetes?
It controls the diabetes. Yes, it controls the diabetes. Because it controls the digestion, or it avoids the fermented matter which is in the small intestine. Mm-hmm. So it stimulates the pancreas for the secretion of insulin or for the formation of insulin. What happens in the diabetes? There is a small formation or very low formation of the insulin. So we activate the pancreatic cell, because one branch of vagus nerve goes to the pancreas, and whenever there is activation of vagus nerve, there is activation of pancreatic cell. So it stimulates pancreas to secrete or to form more insulin inside the islet of pancreas, that is their beta cells.
So could that cure diabetes?
Yes. That is not in insulin dependent diabetes, but in non-insulin dependent diabetes it is a curative.
Yeah.
Okay. So in non-insulin dependent diabetes it is a remedy. Yes? See, stomach is supplied by vagus nerve. Okay, also some branches of mesenteric plexuses. Also some branches of mesenteric plexuses supplies to the stomach and small intestine, and also they supplies to the large intestine. Now this is the another route of nerve impulses towards the digestive tract. One is from vagus nerve. And another is from the mesenteric plexuses, that is lies in the some parts, some centers lies in the near the sacrum, and some centers lies in the lumbar region, either sympathetic and parasympathetic ganglions, you know, which forms the mesenteric plexuses. Now what happens whenever there is an anti-peristaltic action or there is a gross movement in the small intestine and the stomach, it stimulates the mesenteric plexuses. And that mesenteric ganglions get stimulated, and also they, since they get overstimulated, it passes the impulse to the large intestine. And so that is the gastrocolic reflex. Gastrocolic reflex means whenever there is an extra movement in the stomach, there is a stimulation to the large intestine. You see, some patients, that is when after taking lunch, they have tendency to to go for the diabetic. You know, most of the patients, because of the overactivation of this mesenteric ganglions. Now, whenever there is an overactive in the stomach, not during normal digestion processes, but usually whenever there is an overact in the stomach and in the intestine, at that time this is stimulated. And so, when it is overstimulated, one branch which supplies to the large intestine, so it gives stimulation to the large intestine. And so, there is a peristaltic movement, not anti-peristaltic, peristaltic movement in the large intestine. And so, sometimes when you are doing Vaman Dhauti, there is an activation of mesenteric plexus and there is an activation of some large intestine, and so there is an act of defecation. Or due to the formation of normal peristalsis, we can defecate the hard substances, hard matter from your large intestine. That is the one of benefit. Another benefit is, why there is a constipation in the large intestine? Usually, when you are concerning with the chronic constipation, now it is a symptomatic, that gastrocolic reflex. But what happens in the chronic constipation, there is a vicious circle. See, due to constipation, there is a indigestion. And due to indigestion, there is a constipation. And that vicious circle becomes makes the too much problem. In case of chronic constipation, who are suffering from the constipation since 5 years, 10 years. Now, in such patients, we are excreting all these toxic materials from our intestine. And so, we are giving opportunity for the proper digestion. So, the habit of regular Vaman Dhauti makes your digestion clear. And since there is a clear digestion, there is no tendency of constipation. So, we can avoid the tendency of constipation through your regular practice of Vaman Dhauti. Another thing is that, you see, in the constipation, due to that overact of defecation, that straining, you know, in constipation there is a straining. Due to straining, what happens? There is a weakness of that mesenteric nerves. Fatigue of that mesenteric nerves and fatigue to the ganglions. And so they become very sluggish. But whenever there is an act of or regular Vaman Dhauti, what happens? Since it stimulates the mesenteric plexuses, since it is a stimulates the mesenteric ganglions, so it gives or it reduces the fatigue or sluggishness in this ganglion. And so, regular Vaman Dhauti means regular stimulation to the ganglions, it avoids the sluggishness or it reduces the heaviness in that ganglions, and it freshness, it gives freshness to that ganglions, and so then there is a proper functioning of the defecation. So it is after, so there are so many, in so many ways it helps, by the helping of the digestion, by the giving gastrocolic reflex, and by the giving more chance to fresh or recharging of your mesenteric ganglions, sympathetic and parasympathetic. In my opinion, firstly try this Vaman Dhauti once a week, then you try to twice a week, and then if it is a very easy, make this procedure very easy and familiar. How we can realize that this process become as a familiar? Since it does not produces the pain, the weakness, then it becomes familiar. And then you can do this Vaman Dhauti not regularly, but day after day, day after day. So, on Monday, then avoid Tuesday, on Wednesday, then avoid Thursday, on Friday. So, day after day you can do. You can add very few salt, not so too much, that is not the specific quantity that you have to take 5 mg of salt or 6 mg of salt. It depends upon your internal condition. If you have some acidity problem, don't use more salt. If you have hypertension, don't use more salt. So, it depends upon your regular practice and regular habit. Effect on hepatobiliary system. Now, effect on the liver and the bile. You know, the bile is made up of which matter? You secrete bile for the purpose of digestion. Near about? It is made up of your cholesterol, which is in the blood. So overall bile is nothing but the part of cholesterol. And it helps in the digestion of fat in the intestine. So what happens? Whenever there is a hypercholesterolemia, whenever there is a hypercholesterolemia in the blood, what happens in the bile, in the liver? That bile becomes more viscous. More viscous. More, that is what we call as a honey-like. So it fails its liquidity. And so there are chances the formation of some gallstones inside your gallbladder. When it becomes more viscous. So that hypercholesterolemia is closely related with your gallstones. Why we are saying that in fatty women there is a formation of gallstones? Because of that hypercholesterolemia. So what happens during woman dhauti? Now see, in woman dhauti there is an opening of this pyloric sphincter. Okay, now I will show the diagram. Have you experienced it? When you are doing woman dhauti, there is with water some yellowish substance comes from your stomach. Have you experienced it? What is that? Or you feel some irritation in the throat or some what we say some sensation of that's a very bitter taste. You know, somehow bitter taste in your mouth and in your tongue. Have you experienced it? That is the thing that your bile. Now see, here is the opening of the sphincter, and at the same time, the bile from your gallbladder. You know, near about 1 or 1.5 liter of bile is secreted from the liver daily in 24 hours, and it has 1 and 1.5 liter. 1 liter to 1.5 liter. How much? You see, in 24 hours. Now see what happens. Now since during woman dhauti, that liver and your gallbladder is stimulated by vagus nerve, there is a movement, and so there is a rushing of this bile from your gallbladder towards the small intestine. Okay? Yes, I am wrong.
Yeah. You are very correct.
There was a funny sound back here.
Yeah.
And so people started laughing.
You see, that too much bile is, there is a rushing of too much bile from your gallbladder to the small intestine. Now since here is an antiperistalsis, that bile comes into the stomach, and from stomach it is the excreta. Antiperistalsis means that anti-gravity movement of the intestine. We have seen when you are ingesting the food and then the digestion, that food goes from mouth to the anus in the gravitational direction. Antiperistalsis means anti-gravity direction. That is the vomiting, act of vomiting. And that too much bile is excreted through your stomach. Now see, if you compare the Vastra Dhauti and Jala Dhauti, that is woman dhauti, in Vastra Dhauti, due to the over stimulation, too much bile comes into the stomach and it gets added to the Vastra. So there is a excretion of too much bile during Vastra Dhauti as compared to the woman dhauti. But still, woman dhauti, there is an excretion of bile. Now what happens when that there is a too much collection of bile in the biliary gallbladder, then there is an increase in the viscosity of the bile. And due to increase in the viscosity, there is a formation of gallstones. Now what happens? Due to vagal stimulation, all this viscous bile goes towards the stomach and then thrown it up. So we can expel the unnecessary viscous bile which is in the gallbladder, and we are giving chance to bring more cholesterol from blood to your liver for the process of formation of bile. So we can reduce the cholesterol level in the blood. But see the procedure how? By using that cholesterol in proper way. Because once you excrete the bile from your gallbladder, we have to, where to manufacture that bile? Okay, once we excrete the bile from your gallbladder in early morning, now throughout the day we want bile. Now liver has to manufacture that bile. Then liver can manufacture that bile with the help of cholesterol which is in the blood. So there is a direction. You see that cholesterol which is in the blood, now we are using this cholesterol which is in, which remains in the blood, and once it remains in the blood it makes the problem. But now we are using this cholesterol. Yes, you understand this fact? So now there is a movement of cholesterol from blood to the liver, and then that cholesterol is changed into the bile, and that bile is used for the purpose of digestion, or in secondary as well is a unnecessary part is a vomiting. So yes, this is the act of vomiting, but you are giving opportunity in the blood that the collection of cholesterol to remove from the body in proper way. Yes?
And so have they shown clinically that blood cholesterol levels lower with the practice?
Yes. After the practice of after the regular practice of Om Dhoti, yes, there is a definitely, we have the papers that there is a lowering of that blood cholesterol. Mm-hmm. And that is the proof that we lower the blood cholesterol by the regular Om Dhoti. So
there has to be a general level, maintenance level of bile all the time then in the gallbladder. So if we extract it through farming, then the cholesterol comes from the blood to help manufacture more bile to bring up.
What happens during the night? You see, during the night there is an over collection of this bile. Not only in the gallbladder, but also it remains. Since there is a fullness in the gallbladder, some remains in the liver. So there is a too much bile in the liver also. Now when we expel the some bile from your gallbladder, that rushes into the gallbladder. You see,
this is very interesting because I know people who suffer from constipation, have high blood pressure, and have high cholesterol also, and comes together with the constipation. Just so lucky. They take pills for this, pills for this, and pills for that.
Instead of that, if we teach them for the simple procedures, it will beneficial, too much beneficial. So this is the effect on hepatobiliary system. So washing of biliary system maintains the normal viscosity of the bile. Vastra Dhoti is very important because it stimulates more secretion.
Okay.
That is the fact, or it is through our clinical experiments that it has shown that as compared to the Vaman Dhoti, Vastra Dhoti acts more on the biliary secretions. So when you are doing Vastra Dhoti, we will see the diagram that there is a more secretion of bile from the gallbladder, and there is a more secretion or excretion of that bile through your mouth, or it gets attached to the vastra. In case, some cases of hypertension, it can make as a remedy. Okay, the hypertensive patients who has more giddiness, who has not controlled by the medicine also, and who has renal hypertension, and who has very fluctuating BP, they have to avoid, or they have some ischemic attacks, they have to avoid this procedure. Otherwise this procedure is very simple, and in some other patients of hypertension we can use this procedure as a remedy.
Right, because it's a catch-22. I mean, it's good for people that have high cholesterol, which is really high
pressure. Yes, but some patients I am seeing about the high cholesterolemia, who has, what is the difference between the regular Om Dhoti and Kunjal patient? Actually the act of vomiting is voluntary or involuntary? Yes, once there is a starting of the vomiting, that once there is a activation of vomiting center, then from that it becomes involuntary. But see in Kunjal Kriya, though the act of vomiting is involuntary, we can control the act of expelling.
With,
so we can control the movement of that our stomachs and our abdominal muscles. And so there is a specific Kunjal Kriya, you know. So we can control voluntarily this act of vomiting, but in some sort, not 100%. Kunjal Kriya, it indicates your strengthness of or your rhythm, good strength of your abdominal muscles and diaphragm. So it indicates the healthiness of your diaphragm and your abdominal muscles. It indicates the healthiness of your diaphragm and your abdominal muscles.
By withdrawing the salt, drawing out.
You see, what I am telling that if there is a mucus of phlegm in the stomach, so when you add some salt in the water, it is easy to liquefy that phlegm, which the viscid sputum, which is ingested through your esophagus and which remains attached in the gastric mucosa, it gets liquefied due to that salty water. Now, effect on the muscles, yes, diaphragm and abdominal muscles are well exercised, you know, that helps to practice like asanas and pranayama. You see, your Uddiyan Bandha. So, Vibhu, what is the significance of this cleaning process in case of pranayama? By giving the strength to your abdominal muscles, that your rectus abdominis, your internal oblique muscles, and your diaphragm, it helps for the proper Uddiyan Bandha, for the proper pranayama. So that is the benefit. So before pranayama or before asana, you have to do this shuddhi kriya, since it clears the organs. Now what will happen when there is a, you see, here is the transverse colon, here is the diaphragm, and if last night you have taken some heavy material and still the digestion process is going on, and here is too much gas in your large intestine, bulging of your large intestine, transverse colon, and next morning you are crying in Padmasana for the pranayama. What will happen? And you are pressing your diaphragm on that part which is already bulged by the gases. What will happen? It will become difficult. So there will be no proper Uddiyan Bandha also. There will be no proper Purabha also. And if that pranayama becomes uneasy. And so, clearance of your all stomach, small intestine is very important in case of pranayama. That's why there is a clear-cut Uddiyan Bandha. You see, for good Uddiyan Bandha, we have to remove all the matter, not from the, not only empty stomach. Empty GI tract is very good sentence for this. Not only empty stomach. Empty stomach, empty small intestine and empty large intestine. So, if there is an emptiness in the stomach, small intestine, large intestine, then it is a very easy to perform Uddiyan Bandha, to perform Mulabandha. Otherwise, the fecal matter in the this descending colon, in the rectum, and you are doing Mulabandha. It's difficult. Because that fecal matter once comes in the large intestine, once comes in the descending colon, there is a normal urge to defecate. And by giving Mula Bandha, you are avoiding that normal purge. That is somehow unnatural. See, stomach is supplied by vagus nerve, okay? Also some branches of mesenteric plexuses. Also some branches of mesenteric plexuses supplies to the stomach and small intestine. And also they supplies to the large intestine. Now this is the another route of nerve impulses towards the digestive tract. One is from vagus nerve. And another is from the mesenteric plexuses. That is lies in the some parts, some centers lies in the near the sacrum, and some centers lies in the lumbar system. Either sympathetic and parasympathetic ganglions, you know, which forms the mesenteric plexuses. Now what happens whenever there is an anti-peristaltic action or there is a gross movement in the small intestine and the stomach, it stimulates the mesenteric plexuses, and that mesenteric ganglions get stimulated, and as they, since they get overstimulated, it passes the impulse to the large intestine, and so that is the gastrocolic reflex. Gastrocolic reflex means whenever there is an extra movement in the stomach, there is a stimulation to the large intestine. You see, some patients, that is when after taking meal, after taking lunch, they have tendency to go for the diet. You know, most of the patients, because of the overactivation of this mesenteric ganglions. Now, whenever there is an overact in the stomach, not during normal digestion processes, but usually whenever there is an overact in the stomach and in the intestine, at that time this is stimulated. And so, when it is overstimulated, one branch which supplies to the large intestine, so it gives stimulation to the large intestine. And so it there is a peristaltic movement, not anti-peristaltic, peristaltic movement in the large intestine. And so sometimes when you are doing Vaman Dhauti, there is an activation of mesenteric plexus and there is an activation of some large intestine, and so there is an act of defecation. Or due to the formation of normal peristalsis, we can defecate the hard substances, hard matter from your large intestine. That is the one of benefit. Another benefit is, why there is a constipation in the large intestine? Usually when you are concerning with the chronic constipation, now it is a symptomatic, that gastrocolic reflex. But what happens in the chronic constipation, there is a vicious circle. See, due to constipation there is a indigestion, and due to indigestion there is a constipation. And that vicious circle becomes makes the too much problem in case of chronic constipation, who are suffering from the constipation since 5 years, 10 years. Now in such patients, we are excreting all these toxic materials from our intestine, and so we are giving opportunity for the proper digestion. So the habit of regular Vaman Dhauti makes your digestion clear, and since there is a clear digestion, there is a no tendency of constipation. So we can avoid the tendency of constipation through your regular practice of Vaman Dhauti. Another thing is that, you see, in the constipation, due to that overact of defecation, that straining of straining, you know, in constipation there is a straining. Due to straining, what happens? There is a weakness of that mesenteric nerves, fatigue of that mesenteric nerves, and fatigue to the ganglions, and so they become very sluggish. But whenever there is an act of or regular Vaman Dhauti, what happens? Since it stimulates the mesenteric plexuses, since it is a stimulates the mesenteric ganglions, so it gives or it reduces the fatigue or sluggishness in this ganglion. And so regular Vaman Dhauti means regular stimulation to the ganglions, it avoids the sluggishness or it reduces the heaviness in that ganglions, and it freshness, it gives freshness to the that ganglions, and so that there is a proper functioning of the defecation. So it is after, so there are so many, in so many ways it helps, by the helping of the digestion, by the giving gastrocolic reflex, and by the giving more chance to fresh or recharging of your mesenteric ganglions, sympathetic and parasympathetic.